doing sweet. Hey, this is Charles, reporting from the LA Amp Show 2011. I'm here with Doug Cower, boss man, head honcho at Cower Guitars. How you doing, man?
Good, man. How about you guys?
I'm pretty good. I'm digging the sounds over here.
Thank you.
They just keep going and going and going. Cool. And this is, what are we hearing here?
So this is our new Daylighter Express model. We basically brought a junior out about 6 months ago. And, you know, of course, immediately we get, are you going to do a two-pickup version? Are you going to do a two-pickup version? So we caved after about 3 months and finally started prototyping it. And so we tried to just take our straight junior and do nothing else but add a neck pickup to it, added a kind of a universal pickup route so that there was a lot of flexibility and, you know, you could order up a humbucker with any combination at the neck, or a lot of times we'll set up quick connects and do multiple pickups and pick guards for people, and just kind of our bare bones slab Spanish cedar neck body guitar that's kind of a simple let's just go crazy guitar.
Not a lot of folks using cedar though out there in the electric guitar world though.
No, it's horribly misnamed wood. I mean, it's a South American mahogany, really lightweight, really toneful, very resonant. It's got a quality that we just really seem to like, and it's kind of a little hidden gem that people don't seem to realize. So
I was playing this thing earlier, and that's a great feeling neck. It's more substantial than a lot of necks you feel out there. What prompted that decision?
Yeah, we do tend to carve. I mean, I hand carve our necks, so anybody can order whatever they want. Mm-hmm. Our kind of standard neck, you know, when we first started doing this, we show up at shows with like 15 different neck carves, and it seems to be that this kind of profile that I kind of describe as Gibson R8 meets Big Fender meets, you know, something in that range tends to be one that everybody likes. And what it is it's an R9 in thickness and taper, so it's like 89, 90 at the nut, tapers up to about an inch at the 12th fret. The big difference is instead of being really broad in the shoulders like a Gibson neck can be, or most bound fretboard necks can be, we would bind our fretboards and then roll that neck profile right through, so they're a lot slimmer in the shoulders and they don't feel as fat. But it lets you have a nice thick neck otherwise. And, you know, I like doing them that way. They're a little bit more stable. People have their own conceptions about tone differences for big versus skinny. To me, if it's comfortable, that's what you're going to sound best with regardless. But it's a nice, stable, good sounding neck, and it seems to work for about 90% of our orders, honestly.
Yeah, it feels great, man. Now, do you have anything else here amid the vast armada of Cower guitars that's new that we should know about?
So there's basically a bunch of variations on the Express theme here. Like, this is a Telecaster bridge, very first one we've done that. And with that same universal route, it's got a mini in the neck on this one. That one's a humbucker and a P90, same boat. The three P90 one, that's also new. That's the first Express with that. And the first Daylighter period with a Strat Trem bridge. And then, you know, a couple other variations of the Junior theme, the Rat Rod Juniors and Formica Tops, which are all options for the Expresses. And, you know, we just tried to build this thing to be, it's a nice in-betweener. I mean, it's kind of SG-esque, you know, in terms of compared to maybe our Maple Cap versions. It's definitely on that end of the spectrum. But it's got such a great wide range of tones out of it that the Expresses have just become really, really good for us.
It seems like you're really customer geared too. You'll build just about anything.
I try to. I mean, like the Trem Bridge is a perfect example that for the last 3 years people have been asking me, will you do a Trem Bridge? And every time, yeah, no problem, just order one. And, you know, for whatever reason, nobody's actually ordered one yet. So the shows are great excuses for me to build that version of the guitar that nobody's asked or really ordered but's asked about. And so now it's done. It exists. We can do it at any time. It's a full-time option now. And I don't really charge based on the options. It's, you know, if you want a Trem with a humbucker and a bridge and a P90 in the neck, no sweat. We'll do it. But we don't, you know, we'll try to make this model lineup as flexible as possible for people to find a combo that works for them.
Cool. All right. This thing sounded like a big piece of chocolate cake with butter on top. So let's check it out one more time, huh? plug, man. Where do we go to find out more about what you're doing? Because there's a lot you're up to, huh?
Yeah, it seems to keep us busy. Our website, Kaur Guitars, K-A-U-E-R, guitars.com. Our Facebook page especially. We do a lot of stuff on there every day. That's the most current source for news for us, always, is on there. So either place.
Awesome. All right. I'm going to go check it out myself tomorrow. All right. This is Charles reporting from the LA Amp Show 2011 for Premier Guitar. Cheers.